As much of the country covers up under a sweeping return to pandemic control measures, there is no masking the scale of the threat. Queensland joins much of Australia now enforcing the lockdown of millions. Metropolitan areas in Western Australia for 4 days after a case of the Delta variant was discovered late yesterday. In the Territory, Greater Darwin's snap closure has been extended until the end of the week. And Sydney, working to contain the nation's largest cluster, is in the early stages of a long fortnight.
It's early days, and I don't want to regret what I'm about to say, but we had anticipated potentially a surge in cases by today. That could very well happen in the next few days.
19 cases for the state recorded to 8 p.m. last night, still somewhat of a relief, with only two still under investigation and unlinked. From the New South Wales Treasurer, a support package for impacted small businesses.
We will get through this next couple of weeks.
Queensland, the only state not to do the same.
All they need is certainty in an uncertain world, and that's what we're fighting for.
But while the Shadow Treasurer claimed it was the Sunshine State that owes the nation an apology...
For the Queensland hotel quarantine failure that has led to half the country being put into lockdown.
State leaders say that blame lies at the feet of the federal government.
The reason why we're having lockdowns in major cities is because the overseas arrivals are bringing the virus here, they're going into hotels, and all of our staff are having to deal with it. There are so many staff involved, the risk is real.
Anastasia Palaszczuk says capping international arrivals would reduce that threat immediately.
To alleviate the pressure that you see the states are under at the moment, and it's a lot of pressure.
If it's a choice for me between less people coming back, and yes, there would be pain with that, or locking the whole place down, that's not a difficult decision.
The pushback, part of a relentless condemnation of two key areas of federal responsibility.
Our community should have had a higher rate of vaccination by now, and we should have dedicated quarantine facilities.
Like Howard Springs,
yep,
up in the Northern Territory, they've had no breaches there, I don't think, because it's built properly. It's built for this.
That's what everyone is waiting
exactly.
for.
Exactly.
Chris Campy for 10 News First.